Hello humans, welcome to Valent Skills Hacking University. Today we will speak about DNS server. What is a DNS server? If you have seen my previous tutorial on computer networks, you might be knowing by now that the computers will communicate with each other with an address known as the IP address. The computers can only identify the IP address rather than a name. If we consider the case of humans, the humans can understand or remember names more than the numbers. For example, we can easily remember the address of different places, but we cannot remember the latitude and longitude of that place. It's just the opposite in the case of computer systems in a network. If a computer wants to communicate with each other, internally, they need to know the IP address of the other system or server. Suppose, if we want to visit the website google.com, we usually type google.com. We humans cannot remember the IP address of Google, which is 216.58.197.78. Like this, there are hundreds of websites that we daily use. We cannot remember the IP address of each of those websites. So to close this gap between the humans and the computers, we are using a system or a server called DNS, aka Domain Name Server or Domain Name System. The purpose of the DNS server is to convert the human readable address name to the computer readable IP address. Suppose you want to go to google.com. We will type the domain name google.com in our browser, example Google Chrome. The browser will now send a request to the DNS server. The DNS server will now search through the database to see if it has a matching IP address for google.com. If the DNS server finds a match, then the DNS server will resolve the IP address and the system can now retrieve the web page from the Google server. So, in a way, we can say the DNS is working like a telephone directory book. When you want to find a number of a person, you will not look for that number in the book. You will look for the name and then retrieve the number. I hope you got the basic understanding of the working of a DNS server. Now, let's get into more details of how the DNS works. Step 1. You type google.com in the web browser. If the browser or the operating system can find the IP address of google.com in your system itself, it will use that. If it is not found in your browser cache or your operating system, then the browser will send the request to a server called the resolver server. Typically, it's a server maintained by the internet service provider. Step 2. The resolver server receives a request. If the resolver server finds a match in the system, it will return the IP address. If the resolver server cannot find a match in the system, the resolver server will forward the request to the next level, what we call as a root server. A root server sits at the top of the DNS network hierarchy. There are only 13 root servers in the whole world, and it is managed by 12 organizations. We are not going into details of that one now. Step 3. The root server has a request now, but the root server doesn't have the IP address information of that domain name. But it does know which server may have the IP address. So, the root server will tell the resolver to redirect the request to another server called top-level domain or a TLD server for the .com domain. Since it's google.com, it will send it to .com's TLD server. If it was .org, the root server will redirect the request to the TLD for the .org domains. Step 4. The TLD server for the .com domain has a request now. The TLD server also won't be knowing the IP address of google.com, but it will tell the resolver server to forward the request to the final level server called another trading name server. The authoritative name server will always have the entry for all the .com domains. They are the final authority and have all the domain information including the IP address. So when the request reaches the authoritative name server, it will find out the IP address of the domain name google.com and send it back to the resolver. Step 6. The resolver now has the IP address of google.com. It will send the response to the computer from which the request was originated. Also, it will save the details in the resolver server itself, so that the next time when we make the request, we don't have to go through all these processes again, and the resolver itself can send back the IP address. That's it. All the processes happen in seconds, and we won't feel a lag. I hope you liked the tutorial. I'll be adding more tutorials very soon, so please click subscribe right now. Thank you.